Here we go. Power Platform and Dynamics 365 Wave 1 2022. My top 10 in 10 of the roadmap for April to September this year. Make sure you stay till the end. There are three big features around sales, marketing, and a whole new way that we're going to be able to create tables in Dataverse model-driven apps, which I am, even by my standards, very excited about. But let's talk about this first. This is a really awesome new thing that is coming to Power Platform in Power Automate. Now, this is a small feature with a big underlying piece, and I often like to put those ones in for that reason. Odata editor improvements. Now, there's a huge theme around Power Platform of more advanced low-code, easier experiences, making it easier for people to get started, and this is one of those things. So this is what it will look like, and it will start with the SharePoint Get Items connector, but that's just the first, and it's going to be, you know, rolled out over time. What this means is OData usually means you have to know the syntax. You actually have to be able to put in formulas. I know when it's me, I have to go away and search for it and Google it. So when I'm creating a flow in Power Automate, that can become a bit of a barrier to what I'm able to do as someone who doesn't know that syntax well. So what we're seeing here is the ability to do it with that genuinely low-code drop-down experience. So small starting point with that one action, but big platform direction there that is a space to watch. At number 9 here, Power Virtual Agents starting a conversation knowing what's going on. So instead of you coming along and saying, you know, hey, chatbot, can you help me? Or the chatbot saying, hi there, how can I help you? The chatbot will now be able to understand the context of the pages that you've browsed in the website or other things you've done and start a conversation saying, hey, I see you're interested in this. How can I help you with that? So a much richer experience there for Power Virtual Agents, being able to really engage the customers and have a better chat experience rather than feeling like you're starting from scratch. At number 8, AI Builder, support for unstructured documents. We've had a lovely journey from a form processing model through to structured document models like an invoice processing model. And now, next level, you'll be able to use an AI model to extract metadata from unstructured documents, think statements of work, letters, contracts, those kinds of things, where you want to be able to extract the amounts, the dates, the names, the terms and conditions, especially around those legal documents, but the document is different every time. AI Builder will now support those scenarios as well, which is awesome. At number 7, editable grids in model-driven apps. Now, I feel like we might have seen part of this announced before, but this is definitely coming now, public preview April 2022. We got a new experience. This is what it looks like for the views or the grids in model-driven apps and Dynamics 365 as well. Don't forget, Dynamics 365 is a model-driven app. This is going to become inline editable. What this means is I would be able to go in here and change stuff without having to click through to the records. A massive improvement to the user experience. Also, infinite scrolling. So at the moment, it defaults to 50 records and you can change the settings to have a longer list, but the default will be that you can just go on and on. And we're also going to see this coming to subgrids. So when you're inside a record and you click open and you want to be able to edit related records, that inline editing experience will be there as well. This is going to be much better for the users. At number 6 here, we have a unified view of activity in the timeline across sales, marketing, service. So this is a preview of what it looks like from the release notes. At the moment, that timeline is capturing the activities from Dynamics 365. So I create tasks, emails, notes, all of those kinds of things in my sales application or my customer service application. But everything that happens through my digital channels, my marketing channels, you have to go separately to the Insights tab to see it. And so this is a question I get a lot from people. I want to be able to see that all together. And of course, you don't want to be copying all of that data across from all of those marketing insights in there. So we're going to see this coming through now where you can visibly see where you can see all of these things in the timeline together. So if I'm a salesperson, I can come in here and I can see my sales interactions and comments and notes alongside this person just opened an email, this person was just sent a campaign. So truly 360 degree view in that timeline. At number 5, triggering journeys based on data changes in Dynamics 365. This is in the marketing application, and stick with me because I could almost have done a top 10 in 10 in marketing alone. It's a huge amount of stuff coming. This, we've already seen an announcement previously late last year around being able to trigger Power Automate flows from within a journey. So this is sort of another piece that's along these lines, being able to trigger based on what's going in your dynamics data. So if you update a contact record or a new order comes in or any of those things are going to be made available to the journey. We've got to think about customer journey orchestration more than just marketing automation here. So we can use this to trigger tailored communications based on those data points in Dynamics, but we can also be using it to trigger actions, to notify someone to do something in another system, all of those kinds of things. So very, very rich experience coming pretty soon actually around being able to work with that journey automation, journey orchestration for marketing and other scenarios, not just automation of marketing communications. I have to put a Teams thing in, don't I? This one actually is a big deal. Create and join Teams meetings from in-app appointments. This is something that I've seen on the forums. It's been a requested feature for a good couple of years, and especially now around digital selling scenarios, around the bigger picture from Microsoft of wanting to say, we allow people to stay in the flow of work where they're already working without having to switch apps, and Teams and Dynamics becoming, you know, best friends, and we're going to see more of that this year. This is a really, really important piece. So what we'll be able to do is go in and actually have this toggle switch, very similar to what we see in Outlook, to say create a Teams meeting. When I create my appointment from inside Dynamics, I'll be able to set it up as a Teams meeting right from there. I'll be able to join it from that appointment record in Dynamics as well, so no more having to switch to Outlook in order to be able to do those things. At number three, sales mobile, and this is a two for one. It wouldn't be me if I didn't throw in a two for one, right? So this is around being able to have a better experience of making phone calls and having those connect to the Dynamics 365 sales mobile app. At the moment, people always ask, what happens if I make a call to a customer from my mobile phone? It's like, well, the Dynamics app wouldn't know about it. You'd have to go in, find the person, click on their phone number. This is about being able to use your contacts, your address book within your phone and call from there and have that push through to the Dynamics app. So that's going to be a much better experience for sellers in terms of being able to log calls and work with contacts on their phone, which frankly is how they work. So very happy to see this one coming through. As a bonus in here, there's also going to be deep link to Outlook from the Dynamics 365 sales app. So that experience of sending emails from there using templates and so on will also be vastly improved. So Dynamics 365 mobile is getting some cool stuff here in terms of being able to make phone calls and send emails. Now, two big things to finish off here. It's always a tough call between number two and number one, but number one is a big deal that changes the way that we work with the platform. So I've saved that till the end. Here we go at number two, again in that marketing space. I said there was a lot coming here. This is hyper-personalization and next best content selection. So you can create different content blocks, different kinds of offers, different calls to action. And then as you put your journey together, you can choose who gets which ones. So you can have personalized calls to action across the system based on what that customer's preferences, behavior, all of those things have been. And you can branch that in the journey to say this group of people or this person should get this call to action, or start to use AI to decide on the next best offer for you. So that's another piece in that whole journey orchestration, which is going to be pretty much overarching a very big theme this year around how we work with Dynamics 365. And at number one, here we go, quickly create tables in Dataverse. Now, at the moment, when we're creating tables in Dataverse, it's working through a solution explorer experience, low code, yes. But for people who are coming to this from SharePoint or Excel, what we've seen in Dataverse for Teams is a replication of something that's a much easier experience where you can actually edit in line and add your columns in line. This is now what we're going to get in Dataverse for creating model-driven apps. Check that out. And we're also going to be able to, this is the mind-blowing part, import a data table structure from Excel. So you don't even have to go in and create all of this. You'll just be able to effectively upload it in there. So that experience of how we create tables in model-driven apps and opening up that experience to even more people is going to really take off with this feature. There are a heap of other things in the Wave 1 release that I haven't mentioned here because they were covered at Ignite. Make sure you check out my other video that I recorded at the time for some of those big announcements, which have been retrospectively put back into this Wave release.